Hey friends, how are you all? My name is Arshad Dividi and I welcome you back to my video. So in this video friends, I will be talking to you regarding this culture bound syndrome. Now this culture bound syndrome is in news and it has been news for reasons, you know, of cases all around the world. Now recently one case has happened in India. So doctors are saying it that is a case of culture bound syndrome. But it is not that friends, this is happening only in India or only in Asia. It is happening all over the world. And this type of syndrome is found in specified cultures and society. So everything about it, I'm going to tell you. First, let's discuss the event that has recently happened. So what happened friends, that there is a Ambapada village in Dang district of Gujarat. There what happened that three students of class 7th of a government primary school, they repeatedly began to shake themselves, started chanting and crawling on the floor of the prayer hall of the school. They started shouting the name of a local deity and all sorts of unusual activities they started to do. So obviously the school teachers became very much shaken that what is happening now. The school teachers tried to calm down those children, but those children didn't calm down. So obviously child psychiatrist and a health officer were called in order to solve the situation. So when this child psychiatrist counseled the teenager and asked them, then they said that a local deity Dungar Dev, who is hailed as the lord of the hills by the tribals, he was actually upset because there is a particular stone who is buried in the school premises. So through an exorcist, that stone needs to be removed. So this was their statement. Now, for the time being, doctors tried to calm down, but after some time, when they were given this, medicines and they were given some counseling, they started behaving normally. So after the whole treatment and after this whole episode got over, the doctors said that this may be a case of culture bound syndrome. Now, a lot of things are going on, friends. The local politician said that this is because of the, belief of the people, and the people are, their belief in the God is making them do like this. So all sort of things are going on. And doctors are saying that the children are doing these things because the local tribals, the society to which those children belong, in that society, these things is normal. Why normal? Because they worship their deity. Dungar Dev is the name of the deity, friends. And they used to go to the hills. They pray to their God, and when the parents go to the hills, their children also accompany them. So the children see what their parents are doing, and by seeing them, they have inherited those traits and characteristics inside them, and that is why they have developed the culture bound syndrome. So it is being told by the doctor that this is a culture bound syndrome. Now when we talk about culture bound syndrome friends, this culture bound syndrome is present all over the world, and I'm going to tell you many cases of culture bound syndrome. It is basically a mental syndrome, you can say, a sort of mental syndrome. There is no medicines of it. Now what is it? It is said that a culture bound syndrome is a culture specific syndrome, also known as folk illness, is a combination of psychiatric and somatic symptoms that are considered to be a recognizable disease only within a specific society or culture. That is a disease only within a specific society or culture. So the same person, if it will go to some other culture, that disease will not happen. Okay. And there are no objective biochemical or structural alterations of body organs and functions. That body organs and functions are normally functional. There are many small cases where body organs could be damaged or something like this could happen. But normally in almost all the cases of this culture syndrome, body remains fine, body organs remains fine, everything is fine. Okay. And the disease is not recognized in other culture. But in that specific culture, the disease occurs. So you can say that this is totally psychiatric, psychological friends. It is happening in your mind and it is, restricted to a particular society or culture, and that is why it is known as culture bound syndrome. Okay, now let us have a look friends. See, the fourth edition of the Diagnostic and Statistics Manual of Mental Disorders, it is known as DSM-IV-TR list. Then there is a Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, DSM-5 list. Then there is a 10th revision of the International Statistical Classification of Diseases and Related Health Problems. All of these reports have recognized the culture-based syndrome or mental disorders, not mental disorders, culture-specific disorders, culture-specific mental disorders, which are occurring all over the world, friends. So this is not only available in India, this is all over the world, in Southeast Asia, in Africa, South, even in United States, friends. So-called, you know, in even the Scandinavian countries, it is there. I will discuss a case of Scandinavian countries with you also. So these type of disorders are present all over the world, friends. It is not only in India, and these sort of disorders are very varied, because it depends on your specific culture, society, what type of things are happening here. And then according to that, you inherit this disorder. Not all the people are having it, but some are having it. For example, you know, in United States, consumption of kaolin has been proposed to be a culture-based syndrome. It is observed in the African Americans, those Americans who have came from Africa and settled down in America, in rural South, especially in those areas where mining of kaolin is common. So in those areas of United States of America where mining of kaolin is common, the African Americans are known to consume kaolin. So this is a sort of culture specific disorder there. Then it is said that in South Africa, among the Xhosa people, there is a syndrome known as Amafufunyana. So it is said that people are possessed by demons and other malevolent spirits. And there are traditional healers who perform exorcism to get those people rid of those spirits. So this culture-based syndrome tells that actually they are not possessed by spirits. But that culture-based syndrome makes them think that yes, they are possessed by spirits. And then when exorcism is being performed by them, they feel that yes, now the spirit is gone and I am fine. Okay, similarly, friends, also see, when this phenomenon of the spirit was investigated, all of these things were done. So it was said that people who were affected by the syndrome, they were displaying the characteristics of schizophrenia. Okay, now schizophrenia is a disorder that affects a person's ability to think, feel and behave clearly. So they become a very lot of confused. So the point is that no spirit was possessing them. They were just acting because of the syndrome, and they started suddenly, you know, behaving as if they are schizophrenic. They are suffering from schizophrenia. And when some healer comes, some exorcist comes to heal them, they feel that yes, they are now healed and they behave correctly. So obviously this is a sort of mental disorder only and nothing else. Then friends, there's one more case I will talk about. For example, there are refugee children in Sweden. What happens sometime that they fall into coma-like states on learning their families will be deported. This condition is known as Uppgivenhet syndrome or resignation syndrome. And it's believed to exist only among the refugee population in the Scandinavian countries, which has been prevalent since the early part of the 20th century. So at some point of time in their life, it has happened that their parents were to be deported, you know, forcibly. Now they are living in our developed countries. Now there is no case of deportation. But yes, that is deeply rooted in their minds, friends. That at some point of time, refugee, were deported, and that is still present in their mind. And that is affecting their mind, and still they are suffering from these things. That is, they fall into coma-like states because they think that their families will be deported. But actually, no deportation is going on there right now. But they are feeling that they will be deported because at some point of time in the past, this has happened to them, to their ancestors. And that is deeply embedded inside their minds. So this is also a culture-specific syndrome. So basically, this culture-specific syndrome is present all over the world. And many different people have different opinions about them for different classes of people. For example, anthropologists and psychiatrists both have different viewpoint about these diseases. For example, the anthropologist says that this problem is relativistic and culture-specific dimensions are there. Whereas the physician and psychiatrist say that this problem is universal and neurophysiological dimensions are there. So obviously different type of people are seeing the problem in their own ways. However, no proper cure of this thing has come out because it seems to be a mental disorder, or even if it is a neurological disorder, for the time being, there is no proper cure of this thing. So this was all the information about culture-bound syndrome, friends. If it was helpful for you, you can follow me on Instagram, subscribe to my channel. So thank you for watching this video, friends. Have a great day. Goodbye.